When a stone is dropped in a calm water, circular waves are spread out along the surface of water in all directions. Since all the particles are at same distance from the center, they are vibrating with the same phase in the same circles. The imaginary line on the wave over which the particles are vibrating in the same phase is called a wavefront. Therefore, wavefront is a locus of all the points oscillating in the same phase. It is a surface of constant phase. The speed with which the wavefront moves outwards from the source is called the speed of the wave. The wave propagates in the direction which is always perpendicular to the wavefront. If we have a point source emitting waves uniformly in all directions, then the locus of points which have same amplitude and vibrate in the same phase are spread over in the shape of spheres. Such a locus is called a spherical wavefront, and the wave is known as a spherical wave. If we have a line source emitting waves uniformly in all directions, then the locus of points which have same amplitude and vibrate in the same phase are spread over in the shape of cylinder. Such a locus is called cylindrical wavefront, and the wave is known as cylindrical wave. At a larger distance from any type of source, such as spherical or cylindrical, a small portion of the wavefront can be considered as a plane and is called a plane wavefront. The wave is known as plane wave. Now, if you know the shape of the wavefront at t is equal to 0, then Huygens principle allows us to determine the shape of the wavefront at later time t. Let us learn Huygens principle. Huygens principle states that every point on the given wavefront may be considered as a source of secondary wavelets which is spread out with the speed of light in that homogeneous medium. The new wavefront is the forward envelope of the secondary wavelets at that instant. Let us consider a diverging wave, and let AB represent a portion of the spherical wavefront at t is equal to 0. Now, according to Huygens principle, each point on the wavefront is the source of secondary disturbance, and the wavelets coming from these points spread out in all directions with the speed of light. Let c be the velocity of light in that homogeneous medium. Let us consider three points P, Q and R on the spherical wavefront AB. If we wish to determine the shape of the wavefront at any instant of time t, we draw spheres of radius CT from each point on the spherical wavefront. Here C represents the speed of the waves in the homogeneous medium. The forward envelope of the small circles is the new wavefront at that instant. Here, A1B1 is the new wavefront. The secondary wavelet must be directed backward as well as forward from the secondary point sources. Then, we would get a surface A2B2 as a back wave. But experimental result does not show any backward wavefront. So, we can say that intensity of the spherical wavefront is not uniform in all directions. It is maximum in the forward direction and zero in the backward direction. Hence, the wavelet and the wave always directed towards the forward direction. Now, let us find out the location of the shape of a plane wavefront after a later instant of time t. Let AB is the plane wavefront at time t is equal to 0. According to Huygens principle, Each point on AB acts as a secondary wavelet. After t second, the radii of these points are ct, where c is the velocity of light. The forward envelope of these spheres gives the shape and location of the new plane wavefront after t second.